Today in Review This Thing, we're going to give you a quick look of the Bergara Wilderness Sierra. This is Adrian with Review This Thing. If you've watched our channel very much at all, you know that we have been pretty big fans of Bergara rifles. So when a friend of ours picked up this Bergara Wilderness Sierra and gave us the opportunity to borrow it and check it out, we were pretty excited. We are going to have a few more videos coming with this rifle, so if you haven't, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and that notification bell so you can make sure you don't miss those. Okay, let's take a quick look at the Bergara Sierra. First of all, it's available in several calibers in right-handed, and there are a number of options available in left-handed as well. But this one is a right-handed 308, so the measurements I'm going to share with you are specific to this rifle. If you want to know more about the other offerings, then you can click the link in the description and check it out. The Wilderness Sierra is built on the Remington 700 platform, so you should be able to easily find rings, rails, trigger, anything that you may want to switch out. It has an overall length just shy of 41 inches, and it weighs just over 7.3 pounds as it is, so it's definitely a carryable size. First, we're going to start our tour with the stock. This stock has the Bergara painted camo, and it also has a soft touch finish, so it should be easier to grip and hold in various conditions. It has what Bergara calls a sporter style stock, but there are some additional updates that are pretty cool. First of all, the length of pull is adjustable, which you know I absolutely love. It comes out of the box right now. It's sitting right at about 13 1/4 inches. It does come with 3/4 inch spacers though. So if you have longer arms, you like it closer to that 14 inch range, you have that option too. Moving up, the next and probably my favorite feature is that the Sierra has an adjustable cheek comb. If you've watched other of our videos, you know that this is probably one of the things I complain about the most, is not being able to get a good cheek weld. The Sierra has solved that issue. It can be easily adjusted with a hex wrench from flat up to about 1 1/4 inches off of the stock. So whatever height you need to be able to get direct alignment with the center of your scope, you should be able to get that. Another feature that I would even call an update is the grip itself. They've put a bit of a palm swell in it, so it's going to be a little bit bigger and fit more fully into your palm. It also is more vertical than the traditional hunter style stock. A lot of times I have trouble resting my hand comfortably and easily reaching the trigger. I have to do this kind of tilt forward deal, but with that more vertical stock, I can hold it and easily reach that trigger and not have to sit in an uncomfortable position. Plus, the grip also has some additional texture that should make it easier to hold on to. As we move to the Forend, you're going to see double swivel studs. So you can obviously use one for your sling and a small bipod, or you can remove both of those and mount a pick rail or Arca Swiss rail for a bipod or tripod mount. Let's stay on the bottom of the Sierra and take a look at the trigger. The Bergaras we've shot so far, I've been a big fan of the trigger. This one, it does have an adjustable trigger that you can do without having to remove it from the stock. I couldn't find where it tells what the adjustability is, but I measured it out of the box just over 2 pounds. And just, again, dry firing it feels very smooth, easy, lightweight. And next to the trigger, you're going to see the bottom metal, which has an M5 cutout. So you can leave it as a flush hinged floor plate, or it's cut such that you can modify it, switch it out, and get an AICS style magazine. Now let's move on to the top. First, you'll see there is a 2-position thumb safety that is very easy to work. The only thing I may not like with the safety is that whenever I'm in a getting ready to shoot position, I am going to have to move my hand up and work the safety and then get back on the trigger. It would be nice if it was a little closer in. As part of the Wilderness series, the Sierra does have the B14 action. As I said, it's built on that Remington 700 platform, so finding things for it should be a piece of cake. It has a spiral fluted bolt, which obviously looks super cool, but those flutes also serve to make it where it ideally is still going to function if you get some dirt, sand, snow, any kind of debris in that area. I like this oversized bolt knob that Bergara uses. It just makes it easy to find and work that bolt when you're kind of in the mix of it and need to be able to do it quickly. And as with other Bergaras we've tested, the bolt, very smooth. We'll lube it up, clean it up, and I'm sure it'll be even smoother, but not too shabby right out of the box. As we move to the barrel, the Sierra in 308 has a 20-inch 4140 chromoly steel barrel with a 1-in-10 twist rack. The barrel has a number 5 taper, and you can see that it has deep fluting, which is going to help cut weight and add some surface area for cooling if you're shooting multiple shots in a row. And you can see that the action and the barrel and the muzzle brake are all coated with a sniper gray Cerakote. Speaking of that muzzle brake, that's one of my favorite features of so many rifles we test now. This is threaded 5/8 by 24, and it actually comes with this Omni brake, which you know is great for decreasing felt recoil. And with that 20-inch barrel, it is a great length for a suppressor without making the gun way too long. And there you have it. There is our quick tour of the Bergara Wilderness Sierra. If you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. We are very excited to get a scope on it, take it out to the range. If you want to make sure you don't miss those videos, like we said, hit subscribe and that notification bell. If you have a Sierra or you've shot one, comment below and let us know what you think about it. And make sure you come back every week. On Sunday, we have a brand new video just for you. As always, thanks for watching. Hey, thanks for watching our Bergara Wilderness Sierra quick look video. While you're here, like it, comment, share it with your friends. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't and click that notification bell. Head over to our website, reviewthisthingtv.com, subscribe to our newsletter and do some shopping. Also check us out on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, and Twitter, also known as X.